Hello world and welcome to a new episode on the Olympus Craft server. Today we are starting off with a bit of an introduction because after a lot of breeding I finally have a Blue Axolotl. Hello Mr. Blue Axolotl, who's glitching because of lag. He looks he's teleporting around. It took me a lot of breeding. You can see my breeding here, 1548 animals bred. Some of this was also pandas and other animals, but the vast bulk of them, I think around 1,200 of those breedings were axolotls, which means I finally have all of the mob heads, with the only exception being the brown mushroom head, which I'm going to be able to get as soon as a thunderstorm comes. We just haven't had one yet. And blue axolotls aren't the only thing I have been grinding. I have been working like crazy in my villager trading hall to get a load of quartz. We have a big project that we're planning to undertake in the shopping district, something to do with the capitalism society, but for that I'm going to need over 20 shulkers of quartz, but I suspect that's going to take us another week or so to collect. I'm in the void. Ah, I see. The lag is really, really bad. Well, I guess I'll continue here. Yes, because 20 shulker boxes is very difficult to come across. Oh, finally. That took a while. The lag is really bad today. Having now gotten those axolotls, I think I've had an idea of what to do in this particular room. Originally, this was going to be the room where all the mob heads were going to go, but there's another room where those can go. That's not an issue. And I think this is the perfect room to have an indoor aquarium. So what I'm thinking to do is create some kind of tunnel system that lets you walk into the aquarium, like through here, for example. And then fill the aquarium with, you know, lots of coral blocks, sea lanterns, and obviously a lot of axolotls and fish. So I think let's just get started. And the best way to do this is to create the path first, I think. Okay, so that's the glass all in place, which means we can then flood the entire area and still be able to walk here in the dry. I really hope this is not leaking on all the redstone. It shouldn't, but you never know. Okay, maybe what I need is some kelp. Okay, let's let it grow for a bit and see what happens. So that definitely worked. We managed to fill in this entire room. And this is, as far as I'm aware, all source blocks. And the system is working quite well. I've started doing it on the other side as well. Okay, I'm going to keep doing this and I'll let you know once I have filled the entire room with water. This is looking a bit crazy now with all of the kelp which has grown. I did this so that I was sure that all the blocks were source blocks, and swimming through this is a bit insane. It's time to take this down, which I think is going to be fairly satisfying if you tell me. So the next step is to actually fill these aquariums with actual animals and with decorations. So first of all, I definitely want to go with a coral block theme. But as for animals, so I definitely want to have, I think this smaller one here, this one's going to be for tropical fish. And this bigger one around me, I think these could have the axolotls, especially the blue axolotls, I think are going to look really cool in here. And also I thought turtles, because I really like turtles as a sea creature and I'd love to have them within my base. So in the meantime, I have collected 22 turtle eggs, so we can start hatching our turtles for the aquarium. And I'm also going to go into a warm ocean and start getting some coral blocks. Alrighty, I think as far as decorations go, that's looking really cool. But let's grab our pride and joys, the blue axolotls. Alrighty, let's release our friends. Oh man, very happy with this. And we've also put in all the tropical fish. So if we go to the other tank over here, we can go in. and have a look at all of these fishes. Yeah, there he is. That's my favourite one. That cyan and white flatfish. That's most of the aquatic animals put in. We're only waiting for these last few sea turtles and then we should be good to go. I've been staring at these eggs for the last half an hour and they still haven't been born. But Code's online and I thought it would be cool to show him what I've been working on. And I know he's been working on his mansion as well, so we can have a look at what he's been doing.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
This thing is huge.
Yeah.
It's the entire room.
It's the entire room, yeah.
Whoa. Oh, yeah, it's blue. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, there's quite a few actually down here.
Yeah, yeah. Look at these. There's a white one.
Mm-hmm. There's all the different ones.
Oh, this is cool.
Yeah, I kind of...
Oh, there's the blue one.
It was just like after all the effort to get the blue one, it was kind of like, gotta show it off, you know, somehow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is really cool. I like this. This is an awesome aquarium. Thank you. Don't see aquariums in like rooms of buildings like this, but with a museum of this size, it kind of makes sense.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
Yeah, there's another blue one. Man, look at these.
But I heard you've been working on something as well.
Yeah, so would you like to come... Oh, yeah, you're behind me, sorry. Would you like to come see my...
Your
project
mansion
that I've been working on this season. Yeah,
yeah.
I finally have some headway, and it's been a long time coming. Don't mind all that fire. Don't mind it.
Why is that?
You'll get the explanation later.
Oh, okay. I mean, this looks phenomenal from here, by the way.
It is huge.
Yeah, I loved the shadows at the bottom.
So right here, this room here, I don't necessarily have a purpose for yet.
Mm-hmm.
Some of these rooms were kind of built more along the lines of just having space to connect some of the other things that I know I wanted to make.
Mm-hmm.
This is just kind of like an entry foyer area here off the portal right here.
Mm-hmm.
Over here is one of the many lounge rooms that we have.
Oh, cool.
Have some bookshelves, you know, some couches. You can kind of sit around the fire and just kind of talk.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Over here is our bar/entertaining room.
I love the piano. The piano
is
great.
Nice little piano here. Yeah, a couple black banners. We'll take the left little corridor down through here. This is our theater.
Ooh.
You can come in here to watch our movies. Everybody can kind of grab a seat, you know, and watch a movie up there.
My favorite movie, Crazy Child with Llama Demon.
Crazy Woman Child that... has a
llama
squared
demon.
Off pig demon.
Yeah, that's my favorite movie of all time.
Yeah, honestly, it's always been one of my favorites as well. You gotta have diamond blocks in your water feature, you know.
I was
and
gonna say
going right through it, so you know, just details.
Definitely,
right?
A good flex there. Yeah, I like it.
Over here is the hot tub room. Or
nice.
Maybe swimming room, but you know, nonetheless, you can come in here and relax and swim. This is another little living area. Nice little couch here with a view of a TV or something there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my favorite TV show, Hand Goes Into Flame and Plato Comes Out from Said Flame.
Man into flame, Plato out of flame.
Yeah, that's
are we resurrecting Plato here? That kind of really looks like necromancy here.
Yeah, it's my favorite show, as I said before.
My favorite show. And back through here again, just another like sitting area. There's a little viewing couch right here, so you can kind of view out to the vast nothingness.
That's awesome.
You know, sometimes you want vast nothingness. Yeah. Another bed here, and then this one has a little bathroom off to the side here. Actually, it's got a quite nice large tub.
Yeah, this is a big bathroom.
You can swim in that at this point. So
yeah, I quite like this. For my own house, really.
I'll take this, yes. Yeah. When I get that done.
Yeah, and you can sit in here and look at my favorite painting. Two guys fighting on
Karate
a hill.
Karate Man on a square blocky hill.
Yeah, that's my favorite painting.
That's honestly my favorite as well. Oh, goodness. But there is one thing that I just finished today that I would like to show off to you.
What? Oh my god.
And we can just hammer them. Woo, that frame lag. Ooh, wow. That's impressive.
Oh my god. Oh, it goes all the way to the mountain at the back.
Yeah, they kind of shoot upwards a little bit, so.
This is a bad idea, but press the button.
This is probably a bad idea.
Press the button, Code.
Here. All right, after here, and flipping the button. Now. Here they come! Oh, they're everywhere!
Oh, God.
Totally gonna run myself out of fire charges, but that's okay.
Oh, yeah, okay.
It's worth it.
So as well as working on the aquarium, I have been adding more exhibitions to the museum. And there's one specific one which I think you should have a look at. As you can see, it's the Mobhead walls. I have spent hours collecting every single Mobhead on the server. You can see we got all the different villagers, all the different zombie villagers, all the cats, parrots, different types of wither, illagers, horses, miscellaneous ones over there. These are the ones you could originally get on the server. We've got all the axolotls, we've got bees, we've got screaming goat, we've got lots of types of fish, we've got a charged creeper head as well, we've got all of these panda heads, different llamas, different rabbits, all the sheep, and a few miscellaneous ones as well. So this is a super cool collection. I'm really happy to have put all of this together. So I've been collecting a lot of naturally generated structures, such as this pillager outpost, but there's one which I haven't really considered or even explored, and that's a woodland mansion. So I thought that today I could go and visit the woodland mansion, and there's one particular thing that I want to collect from it. Ooh, here it is. This is cool, this is floating on water essentially. Okay, shield ready. Am I ready? Maybe. Oh, okay. That's our first enemy. Oh, this is actually terrifying. Oops. Nope, nope, nope. That's not good. Johnny. Oh, nope, 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 friend. Nope, nope, nope. Okay, cool. Okay, I think that's the ground floor cleared. So let's go upwards. Ah! Ah! No, 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 wait a second. No, no, don't, no, 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 no. Oh, okay, okay. That actually gave me a heart attack. Oh. Oh my God. This place is scary, guys. Ah! No, no, no! I'm stuck in a room with him! No, 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 no! No, 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 no! No, Johnny! Johnny, behave! Oh, okay. No, don't like that one. Oh, God, I hate vexes. Oh, it's not one of those! No! No, come on, come on. Just, no. No, I need to kill it before more things appear. Just, please die. Oh, no, we got lag. This is very unfair. This is very unfair. I've got so much lag. No, come on. But I definitely want this fella. Let's finish this off and then we can think about what we want to take home. Okay, I think that's essentially the Woodland Mansion. What I am interested in getting is the cat. Because actually that cat fits better in the museum than the chicken would. Yeah, let's take this beautiful baby down. There we go, Chief Detective Meow Meow is right behind me here. He's my Sphinx. I thought it would fit quite well within kind of the desert area because he does look a lot like a Sphinx. And with this lovely cat in the background, that is unfortunately the end of the episode. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please remember to comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next one. Bye!